conditionals.com, and I help people like you reach a high level of English. And this is a live lesson. This is being recorded live. So if you are watching the replay, check out the description and learn how you can watch these lessons live. We're going to look at idioms, hope and wish, lots of different vocabulary, and I'm going to answer your questions. But first, I have to say, what a morning. It's been a crazy morning. I'm going to explain why in a second, but there's definitely something in the air today. And Donald Trump is going to become president today as well. A lot of people are upset about this. A lot of people feel down. It's just one of those days. But the good news is we're here to learn English. We're here to improve ourselves. And I'm going to help you do that. More good news. I have got this new, see if I can show you without breaking it, this new microphone stand. Now, in past lessons, whenever I touch the table, it will go dum, dum, because the vibrations from the table went to the microphone. But now I have this standalone microphone stand. It's not connected to the table. And fingers crossed, hopefully, it's going to be much better. It's going to be much better. Okay, with all that in mind, let's have a look. Let's bring up the comments. Let's see who is here today. So we've got Grace here. Dridri Slava is here again. Great to see you. We've got Nika from the Philippines. Manuel from Spain. Heba, Michelle, Kazil, Paulo. What's the thing you're wearing called? This. Okay, this is it's like a pullover, I think, or a quarter zip sweater. A quarter zip sweater because the zip only goes down one quarter. But it's probably, you can just call it a sweater or a jumper in British English. This is my first time live. Anna, good to have you here. The messages are coming through quickly. Ador from Brazil. Charles from Cardiff. James from Brazil. Carlo from Peru. Roque from Brazil. Oman is in the house. It's coming through very quickly. Thank you if you are here live. So, I've got a couple of things to share with you. First, like I said, this is a live English lesson. I was going to do this on what day? I was going to do this on Wednesday, but I got sick. But now I am recovered, so we are doing it today. So usually we do this every Wednesday at 10:30 a.m. And if you just go to fluency.com/live, it will take you to the lesson. It will take you to the lesson. But like I said before, what a morning. What a morning. What a morning. It's been crazy. It's been crazy. So let's have a look at this. What a morning. What's interesting, I can use this in a positive way or a negative way, or just I've been busy way. So I'm using this in a negative way. It's not been the best morning, okay? It's been crazy. So firstly, we had a problem with our washing machine. I'm not going to tell you the exact details, but it's not very good. So our washing machine is broken and we have quite a big problem because of that. And then my son didn't want to go to school. Normally he wants to go to school, but today he just didn't want to go. And also I hardly slept last night. So I couldn't sleep last night and I didn't get enough sleep. So the washing machine broke. My son didn't want to go to school. I had to stay with him for about half an hour, 40 minutes in his classroom. I didn't sleep well last night. And then also at school, there was a really strange atmosphere. Let's go back to this, okay? So it's been crazy. Now, I'm using the present perfect here. It's been crazy, okay? It has been crazy because the morning is still here. It is still morning. It's been crazy. Later, I can say, it was crazy. This morning was crazy. But I say that in the afternoon, not while it's still morning. So it's been crazy. I'm just going to go to the comment section before I share the next one. It's my first time as well. Very cool. What a morning. What a late night. It's amazing. Glad to have you here. We've got Dante from Argentina. We've got Kamadu from Cambodia. Sorry about the pronunciation. Cancer says insomnia. Yeah, insomnia is the affliction of when you just can't sleep at night. I don't normally have insomnia. I normally sleep really well. But yeah, last night. Yeah, someone said it's like when you have a new moon. People say when it's a full moon, things are a little bit crazy. Let's go back to this because I've got a couple more things for you. There's something in the air. There's a strange atmosphere, okay? So look on your screen. You can say there's something in the air. There's a strange atmosphere today. And there really is. I think a part of it is the inauguration today of the new president. And a lot of people aren't very happy. People are really down about this. And because of that, there's just a really strange atmosphere. There's something in the air. So we talk about this when things feel a little bit different, when things don't go well. But I've got something for you, which I think is incredible. This is an idiom. You've got to roll with the punches. Let's repeat this. You've got to roll with the punches. You've got to roll with the punches. Now, this is an idiom taken from boxing. So a boxer, if someone is trying to hit you like this in a boxing ring, you can do this, you can do that. Roll. Okay, my boxing style isn't very good. But you understand, because when punches are thrown at you, you have to try to avoid them. And this idiom means when bad things happen, when things are a little bit crazy, you have to deal with them. You have to deal with them. You have to be quite stoic. You have to just say, okay, how can I solve these problems? Because things can get really overwhelming. If you're in a boxing ring and someone is punching you, it can be really overwhelming. But you have to stay focused and you have to try to avoid those punches. You have to roll with the punches. So that is where that idiom comes from, and it's perfect for today. So I am going to roll with the punches, stay optimistic, and just keep on going. Because, again, you know, these problems are small problems. It's not like anything really bad has happened. Yes, they are annoying, but you've got to roll with the punches. Let's go to the comment section. Okay. I'm just going to move this over here. So we've got Fatmunar from Turkey. I never knew you were from Turkey. It's good to have you. Michelle says, just before the snow falls, the atmosphere is strange. That's very true. And just before a storm, the atmosphere is strange as well. And it's called the calm before the storm. The calm before the storm. Where everything is very silent and calm and still. But there's that strange atmosphere, that energy building. And things can really change. Fanny from France is here. Philippe is from France as well. Oh, we have someone from Kathmandu. Very cool. Hello from India. I love your classes. Thank you, everyone, for being here. So let's just have a quick recap. What a morning. We can use this in a negative or a positive way. What a morning. It's been crazy. Or you can say, what a morning. It's been amazing. There's something in the air. There's a strange atmosphere. But when things go wrong, you've got to roll with the punches. Now, notice with this one too, I use gotta. That's more American English, but a lot of people in the UK use this as well. Somebody asked, what do you mean by overwhelming? Okay, if something is overwhelming, it means that it's too much. It's too big of a problem. And then you can't really deal with it. So sometimes when things are overwhelming, you cry. You know, you break down and you cry because you just don't feel strong enough and you don't have the energy to deal with things. So whenever a lot of bad things happen, it can be overwhelming. And you can say, I feel overwhelmed. If you have too much stuff to do, you feel overwhelmed. Like, oh, I don't know how to do all this. Can I do it or not? You feel overwhelmed. You always talk about your son. We want to see him. Yeah, I'm not going to show my son in the lessons because he's not old enough. He's not old enough to decide that yet. So maybe when he's older. Bonjour de France. Good to have you, Daniel. Great to have you as well. I'll come back to that, Slava, about video games. Because right now, what we're going to do, I'm going to talk about this a little bit. This is my friend Ellie. Did you watch this vlog? Just having a drink of water. Did you watch this vlog? And also, let me know if the microphone sounds better today. But did you watch this vlog? This was a vlog that I did last week. Someone says, Privet. Good to have you here. Probably from Russia. But this is a vlog that I made where I met my friend, Ellie. And if you haven't seen it, definitely watch it. Look for it on my channel. I did it last week. Now, in this vlog, somebody asked me about the camera that I use. And I'm using this camera right now. Luckily, I can use this during the live lessons as well as just making regular videos. But yeah, this is the camera that I use. And somebody asked me what camera I have. And while I was talking about the camera, I said this. I love this camera, but you have to get used to it. I love this camera, but you have to get used to it. Now, to get used to something means to become familiar with something. To get used to something means to become familiar with something. So with the camera, when I first got it, I tried to record a video. It didn't work that well. I didn't know how to change the settings. I didn't know how to do the manual focus. I didn't know how to do a lot of things. But I got used to it. It became familiar to me. And it became normal. It became normal. So after I got used to the camera, I could use it properly. So when we're using get used to, we're talking about becoming familiar with it, the process of this happening. And this reminded me of a couple of examples, especially with what people say. This is an example from my life. It took me a while to get used to American pronunciation. It took me a while to get used to American pronunciation. So at first, American pronunciation was a little bit strange. I couldn't understand it. But after living here for a while, I got used to it. I got used to it. So what I want you to do is to leave me an example in the comment section using get used to. Get used to. What is something that you have got used to recently? What was strange at first, but now you are used to it? Please leave me an example. A lot of people say this, or I can just read this example. If you're new here, it might take you a while to get used to my accent. If you're new here, it might take you a while to get used to my accent. So you can see here also, it took me a while, it might take you a while. It took me a while, it might take you a while. Let's go back to the comment section. Gemma says, to get used to anything takes time. Really good. So we're using takes time here. Great example. Donny says, we had a cold snap this week. We are not used to this weather. Fantastic. So although you're not using get used to, you're using used to in the right way. We had a cold snap this week in Spain, in Andalusia, if I remember correctly. We are not used to this. Naomi, I've got used to the taste of ginger. Me too. It took me a while to get used to the taste of ginger. I've got used to being away from home. Great example. So if you move away from home, things might be strange at first, but it becomes more familiar after a while. I've got used to my new phone. That's something that takes a while. If you get a new phone, it takes a while to get used to it. I'm getting used to listening to English, okay? I'm getting used to listening to English. Okay, I wasn't used to driving on the right in London, but after a while I got used to it. In London, they drive on the left. I get used to watching you, or maybe that's what you meant. I was used to driving on the right, but I had to get used to driving on the left in London. It took me a while to get used to waking up early. Very good. Now I'm used to American culture. I'm getting used to talking in English on the phone. Fantastic. We're getting more and more people here, Jack. Yes. 126 people are currently watching live. This is fantastic. I got used to understanding listening to English when I watched videos. I'm cooking and learning. I'm used to cooking and learning now. Or I'm used to multitasking now. I'm getting used to your live schedule. Fantastic example, Mara. I must get used to thinking in English. These examples are fantastic. These are fantastic. Okay. And one more. Dora says, I have to get used to the timetable when a new school year is starting after such a long holiday. I remember that. I remember when I was at school, and yeah, we started a new year and you had a new timetable. And you didn't know where the classrooms were. You didn't know what time you had PE or maths or something else. And it takes you a while to get used to that. It takes you a while to get used to that. Really good. Fantastic practice, everyone. Let's move on to this video now. Wish versus hope. Guys, did you watch this video? Did you watch this video? And also, thank you for the comments about the microphone. This is a new microphone stand, and hopefully it's going to make a big difference. We won't have those annoying vibrations. Just drinking more water. So, did you watch this lesson, Wish versus Hope? This was a lesson I recorded last week. And I looked at the difference between wish and hope. Now, in the comments, in the description, I left some bonus tips. I left some bonus tips. And one person managed to read that and they spotted a mistake. And let's just go back to the comment section. A few people watched it. Very good. I watched it, so useful. But in this bonus section, I linked hope and wish to conditionals. And we're going to give more examples about this now. Okay? We're going to talk about more examples of this now. A lot of people watched it. This is great. A lot of people watched it. So let's just have a recap, a review, quick review. Hope, we use this when we're talking about desired actions in the past or future. Okay, so desired actions, desired results in the past or future. I'm going to give you a real example. I was hoping to get to the office early this morning. I was hoping to get to the office early this morning, but I couldn't. I was hoping to get to the office early this morning, but I couldn't. And we use wish when we have a change of situation. Okay? We use wish when we want a change of situation. Now, these aren't the only two ways to use these words, but this is the main distinction. And I've got some examples now, but I'm going to link these examples to conditionals. This is going to be fun. First one is this. I said this, or I thought this, when I was sick the other day. I wish I was feeling better. I wish I was feeling better. So this is wanting a change of situation. I wish I was feeling better. I was feeling terrible, but I wish the situation was different. And in that moment, I wish I was feeling better. Okay. And this is an example of using a conditional, which is very similar. I'd be able to teach this live lesson if I were feeling better. So look at this on your screen. This is such a good one. I'd be able to teach this live lesson if I were feeling better. So as I said, on Wednesday, when I was in bed, I had to cancel the live lesson. But I said, I'd be able to do this if I were feeling better. So what we can do here is we can think about wish with the second conditional. Let's go over those examples quickly. I wish I was feeling better. It's better to say here, and I'm going to change this. I wish I were feeling better. You'll notice in spoken English, I wish I was, I wish I were. Both, generally speaking, are fine. It's more grammatically correct to say I wish I were. That's why I changed it. I wish I were feeling better. I wish I were feeling better. I'd be able to teach this live lesson if I were feeling better. Okay? And I'm just going to go to the comment section because we have some good examples. Aram says, I wish I was here earlier. I wish I was here earlier. Great example. I hope I can go to America. So that's like a desired outcome for the future. I hope I can go to America. I hope to catch your next live lesson. Great example here from Chari. I hope to catch your next live lesson. Bishwa says, I wish I could meet you. I wish I could, okay? I wish I could meet you. And guys, let's try and keep the other questions for the end. So at the end of the lesson, we'll go through questions and answers. So if you have questions about learning English or, you know, how to speak in English, listening without subtitles, let's ask those questions at the end, okay? Because we want to keep it on topic. Now, somebody told me this on my Facebook post. I hope you get better soon. I hope you get better soon. So I told everyone I have to cancel the lesson because I don't feel very well. And someone wrote, I hope you get better soon. So this is like a desired outcome, a desired outcome. If I get better, I'll be able to teach this lesson on Friday. If I get better, I'll be able to teach this lesson on Friday. So this is using the first conditional. So think about hope with the first conditional. I hope I get better. If I get better, I'll be able to teach this lesson later. Okay? I hope I get better. If I get better, I'll be able to teach this lesson later. So hope we use with this. The first conditional. Now look at this example. I wish we had planted more trees. I wish we had planted more trees. Now, I talked about this in the video that I made on Wish and Hope, because I talked about the apple trees and I said, I wish we had planted more trees. I wish we had planted more trees. So we can talk about wish in the past, for past actions that we did or didn't do. I wish we had planted more trees. If we had planted more trees, we would have had more apples last summer. If we had planted more trees, we would have had more apples last summer. This is the third conditional. This is the third conditional. So think about wish in the past. I wish we had planted more trees. If we had planted more trees, we would have had more apples last summer. Think about that with the third conditional. Okay, so that is quite advanced. It's quite advanced, but you can see how we can use hope with the first conditional, wish with the second conditional, wish in the past with the third conditional. Okay. I'll leave some examples in the description to help you with that. And be sure to watch that wish versus hope video too. I'm just going to correct some of these sentences. Okay. I wish I were fluent in English. Actually, this is a really good example. I wish I were fluent in English. Now you can say the following. I wish I could speak better English. I wish I were fluent in English. I hope to be fluent in English next year. So the first one, I wish I were fluent in English, is you wanting that change right now. You want this situation to be different. But it's not possible because you can't change it like magic. But I hope to be fluent in English next year. That's a desired outcome for the future. Desired outcome for the future. Let's go back to the comment section. Ador, great example. I wish I'd studied something a little more practical. Chari, I wish I had found your YouTube channel before. These examples, fantastic. They wish they had discussed the matter in depth. Maxime, have you totally recovered? I have. I feel so much better. Grace, I really wish I could speak like you. Could you give me some advice? Okay, I'm going to in a second. It's really confusing when I use would have. Get lots of practice. See lots of examples. Okay, and you'll get used to it. Okay. I wish you stopped going on about all your problems. I thought, really good example. I wish I could talk with you face to face. I wish I could lose weight. I wish you were in my country. I wish my family and I could live in the US. Guys, what a community. This is so good. These examples are fantastic. These examples are fantastic. And it just shows that, you know, you're following the examples, you're practicing, and you're using your own examples. And this is what's really going to help you. So thank you, everyone, for these fantastic examples. Now, also, I've got a quote for you using wish, okay? Don't wish it were easier. Wish you were better. Don't wish it were easier. Wish you were better. That's by Jim Rohn. Don't wish it were easier. Wish you were better. And I love this quote because a lot of the time when we're doing something like learning English, or when we're doing something, in my case, like learning French, it's easy to say, oh, English is so hard. French grammar is so hard. French pronunciation is so difficult. And when we do that, it puts a barrier between us and where we want to go. It's not the right mind frame to have. It's not the right mentality to have. So what Jim Rohn is saying, don't wish something were easier, but wish you were better. And you can get better by doing the right things and spending more time doing them. Okay? Doing the right things and spending more time doing them. So when you are in a situation and you feel like, oh, would have is so difficult, or English pronunciation is impossible, or why are there so many different versions of English? Don't focus on that. Instead, focus on how you can improve so that you were better at would have, so that you can understand different accents, so that you can use English pronunciation well. I think that's a really important thing to talk about. You know, don't wish it were easier. Wish you were better. And you can get better by practice, by hard work, and all those types of things. I've got one more example. I wish I were a millionaire. A perfect example, because look at this example right now. I wish I had $1 million. I wish I had $1 million. I've got a question for you. What would you do with $1 million? Let me know in the comment section. What would you do with $1 million? Because I'm going to talk about what I would do with this. And also, I'm going to talk about what a financial advisor would do with this. Somebody who is an expert when it comes to money. And I think we can follow this person's advice, okay? So what would you do with $1 million? Going to bring up the comment section. We've got so many great examples with wish. I wish I had more money. You can also say I hope to get more money over here. I wish I had a Ferrari. Do you? Because I feel like having a Ferrari would be really problematic. It's not very practical. It's very expensive to run, all those things. I wish I could speak with a British accent. I wish I could travel all over the world. If I had $1 million, I would make a big company. I'd buy a house for someone who hasn't got one. I would travel all around the world. I would visit so many countries. I would buy a great house in England. I'd like to give this money to charity. If I had that money, it would be crazy. I would travel around the world. So we have lots of examples. A lot of people want to travel. I really like that. A lot of people would travel, okay? It's really interesting. So let's have a look at what this financial advisor would do, okay, with the money. Firstly, the main thing he would do is invest. So look at your screen now. Invest. And what I want to say also is this person is giving advice to someone who is already making money or somebody who lives in America. So it might be different to where you are, okay? But this person would invest. And he says, assuming your investment can generate an annual taxable income of 8%, $1 million can generate a nice income of $80,000 per year. Okay, so assuming your investment can generate a taxable income of 8% every year, $1 million can generate a nice income of $80,000 per year. So what he's saying is, if you invest it in the right place, then you can get $80,000 a year from your investment. And what he's trying to say here is, well, most people can live on $80,000 a year. So if you have this money, then you can retire. You can retire. But you have to invest that first. I'm just going to go back to the comment section. I would buy a pharmacy and a new car. If I had $1 million, I would travel around the world. I would study English in an English-speaking country. I'd pay some debts. If I had $1 million, I'd help some poor people. Okay, very cool. If I had $1 million, I'd buy a big house. If I had that money, I'd use it. We're going to talk about that in a second, okay? I would invest money for smart, yeah. I'd invest it in a smart way. And that's what this person is talking about first. So investing. The next thing he recommends, or what he would do, is share. I would also reserve a small percentage for helping close family members, such as parents and siblings, with repaying their own debts, and give another 1% to 5% to charity. So let's read that again. I would also reserve a small percentage for helping close family members, such as parents and siblings, with repaying their own debts, and give another 1% to 5% to charity. So in this case, he would share it with his parents, brothers and sisters, to help them with their debt. And then he would give another small percentage to charity. And a few of you said that you would give it to charity too, that you would help some people. And then the last one is this. And this word is fantastic. Splurge. Splurge. Okay? So on your screen, you can see a Mercedes car. It's bright. And this is the idea of splurging, okay? By the way, my wife, this is really funny. During this, my wife just sent me a message saying, check out this expensive house that we can't afford. It's like she's watching my live lesson and she's saying, well, Jack, if you had $1 million, then you would get this house. Splurge, okay. Now, to splurge means to spend money on things that you don't really need, but an expensive watch, a new car, things like that. And this person would allocate 1% to 5% for splurging. This could go towards buying a new car, renovating the house, or buying new furniture or art. So 1% to 5% for splurging. This could go towards buying a new car, renovating the house, or buying furniture or art. So to splurge means to spend money on things that you don't really need. They are not the necessities. Okay. Sometimes I feel like splurging. I don't splurge that much, but I do feel like splurging. And sometimes I want to buy a drone, for example. I really want to get a drone. If you don't know what a drone is, it's one of those flying cameras. And I really want to get one, but I need to save up some money. So this is what I would do. I would invest it, I'd share it, and travel. Okay, I would invest, share it, and travel. So I'd put the majority in an investment account. I would share part of it, and the splurge would be travel. The splurge would be travel. So let's go back to the comment section. I would use, Dora says, I would use 50% of it as an investment, 25% of it helping people get a job, and 25% for learning. What kind of course is $250,000 for maybe a university in the US? If I had $1 million, I'd learn English. Moreover, I would go to the USA. Very cool. Spend money like flowing water. So you would splurge, just spend it all. If I had so much money, I would be able to pursue my dreams without worrying about mundane things. Paolo, comment of the day. If I had so much money, I would be able to pursue my dreams without worrying about mundane things. Sunak, I would eat sushi all day long till I died. Oh, second best comment of the day. I would eat sushi all day long. Sushi is fantastic. I love sushi. I haven't had sushi for a long time. I would eat sushi all day long. Okay. Someone just had a comment. Splurge things you don't need. Yeah. It's like to spend money on things that you don't need that, you know, you can always say, well, I need a new car. Well, you know, I need new clothes. But it's when you're buying, let's say, a third jacket. You already have two great jackets and you say, oh, but I'd like this jacket. I'm going to buy a new jacket. It's to splurge. It's to spend money in not in a very sensible way or not in a way that is very practical, to splurge. And one more comment. I'd study abroad and become a pediatric surgeon. Very cool. Yeah, to splurge. So I think I would splurge a little bit, maybe. I'd probably buy a drone. And I don't know what else. Maybe a new camera. Although, you know, I've got two great cameras. That's why it's splurging. I don't need a new camera, but I feel it would be fantastic if I got a new camera. Okay, I've got one more thing to go through, and then we'll go to questions. Let's go to pronunciation, okay? I just want to practice this a little bit, because when we're using would, a lot of the time we shorten it to I'd. And this is just short for I would. So let's practice this. No matter where you are, I want you to repeat these sentences out loud. Okay? Are you ready? I'd buy a new car. I'd buy a new car. I'd invest most of it. I'd invest most of it. I'd share it with my family. I'd share it with my family. Very good. And then I thought, do something a little bit different this week to make it more interactive. And feel free to type these answers into the live chat, but also just say them out loud, okay? Especially if you're watching the replay. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a little bit of a quiz, a little bit of a test. There's no pressure. Enjoy this. But complete the sentence. If I to have more time, I'd be able to finish it. If I something more time, I'd be able to finish it. And use the verb to have. 3, 2, 1. If I had more time. If I had more time, I'd be able to finish it. Wish or hope. I, Man United win. I, something, Man United win. Hope or wish. 3, 2, 1. I hope Man United win. I hope Man United win. Just to say, I don't hope Man United win. I'm not a Man United fan, but it's an example. I hope Man United win. If they, using the verb to come, they would have enjoyed it. If they, using the verb to come, they would have enjoyed it. 3, 2, 1. If they had come, they would have enjoyed it. This is the third conditional. If they had come, they would have enjoyed it. Very good. The last one. I'd something the money so that I could earn interest. We've just learned this word. I'd something the money so that I could earn interest. 3, two, one. I'd invest the money so that I could earn interest. I'd invest the money so that I could earn interest. Okay, let's just look at the comment section. A lot of people are getting this right. Had come. This just shows that there is a delay when I'm speaking and then when the comments come. That's why we can't always do quizzes, but I thought that was fun. Okay, a lot of people saying had come and then invest. Really good. Everyone, fantastic. So we're going to go into the part of the lesson now where we're going to do questions and answers, Q&A. So if you have any questions about what we talked about me, about learning English, about anything, ask them right now. This is a bit where we can go off topic, talk about anything. We can go off topic and talk about anything. So while you're thinking about your questions and writing them, if you are new here, and if you don't have my book, go to fluency.com/book to download it. It's called the 5-step plan for English fluency, and it's going to help you improve your English. If you ever ask the question, how do I improve my English? Read this book. If you already have the book, or if you want to get the audiobook anyway, you can do so by going to fluency.com/audio. fluency.com/audio. Okay? And you'll be able to download that book after you enter the details. Okay, let's go to the comment section. The opposite of splurge, okay? The opposite of splurge. So that is what Nabil is asking. What's the opposite of splurge? I'm trying to think if there's a specific word you can use, but to spend your money wisely, that's what it means, you know, to spend your money wisely. To splurge is, you know, spending your money on things you don't really need to use. I thought, Jack, I'm thinking about making a video speaking in English to help me use my shyness and upload it on YouTube. Would you recommend this? Yes, definitely. And if you only want to show specific people, you can upload this video as a private video. You know, in fact, might be able to do something with that where, yeah, we can get people to upload their videos and I can show them. Once you use everyone and everybody, from my knowledge, they're pretty similar. I don't know if there's a big difference. How can someone know when they pass from beginner level to English to intermediate? You can just know by yourself. Go to a video called Level Test and you'll be able to do that. If you just type into YouTube, test your English level to fluency, and I'll show you how to test your own level. I have a question about games. What do you think about... Yeah, so Slava asked about games. And I don't know what you're asking us specifically, but I think you're saying, are games a good way to learn English? They are. They're fantastic. If you find a computer game or any kind of game that you're really into and that has a lot of English dialogue, then it's going to help you. It's going to help you improve your English. I thought, why do you advertise that book? It's very small and there's nothing important. A lot of people disagree with you. A lot of people disagree. I get so many emails from people telling me that it's really useful. It kind of sounds like you're trolling here. How can I reach a high level? News is good or real English? So you talk about news. News is a great way to learn English too. In fact, I recommend you listen to or watch things that you enjoy. And I actually really improve my listening in Spanish by watching the news, because they speak clearly, they speak about topics that you understand. And a lot of the words are quite similar, you know, especially when it comes to politics and science and things like that. So I could understand things a lot easier and pick things up. So I think it's a great way to overcome that listening barrier. I told my daughter that thinking in English is more important than speaking. Do you agree? What do you think about thinking in English? Yeah, I mean, thinking in English is important, but I think it's also important to... When you think about speaking, it's not just about having conversations, but it's about using your pronunciation. It's about mimicking speakers. All these things can make a huge difference. So, yeah, speaking in English, you can do it in many, many ways. Wish is in the passive voice and hope is in an active voice. Nope. It's just that we use wish with the simple past. I wish I had. I wish I had. Whereas hope is used in the simple or the future. Like I can say, I hope you come to my next lesson. I hope you will come to my next lesson. So I wish I had. We're using like the past tense here. But I hope you come. Present, I hope you will come. Future. Hi Jack, I have an interview next week in English to take a visa to the United States. Could you give me some advice or tips to pass it, please? Ooh. I had an interview at the embassy so I could get a visa. And strangely, it was fine. I know some people have problems, but he just asked questions about our hopes and dreams, how we met, in a very friendly way. And yeah, it was fine. It was great. But I can't really give you specific tips when it comes to the interview. But what I would do is research typical questions, interview American embassy, and look at those questions so that you can prepare for them. Sour says, how to remember new words. Lots of repetition. Get them in context. Okay, so repeat the words and get them from a strong context. If you go to, I'll leave a link later, but the sentence method, then you'll be able to use that method to help you learn new words and phrases. Learning through sentences is fantastic. Someone said absolutely and completely. It's hard to do that without doing a lesson and getting some examples. Could you tell us the difference between regards and cheers to say goodbye in an informal chat? Yeah, when you're saying goodbye in informal chat, if you're having an informal conversation, you can say, see you later. You know, that's the most common. See you later. Or bye. Yeah, it's very simple. See you soon. Okay, see you soon. A lot of the times it goes like this. Okay, see you soon. Bye-bye. Bye. So you say a few things when you say it. Jose, when I'm watching your videos with subtitles, I understand very well, but without subtitles, I have difficulties to understand. What do you recommend that I do? Keep listening. Listen as much as possible. Listen, 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 listen. Go to my videos where it's advanced listening practice, right? Look at that playlist. Watch the videos without subtitles. Then watch them with subtitles and then watch them without. It's all about practicing. All about practicing. Are you married to an American? I am. I am married to an American woman. We got married... Oh, why did I say this? We got married in 2009, I think. Yeah, 2009. Whew, a long time ago. She's fantastic. She's fantastic. Few teachers are doing what you're doing. Love your lessons. Thank you so much. Does reading help speaking skills? Or are they different? The more words you learn, the better your speaking will become. But if you want to get focused on your speaking skills, work on your pronunciation and mimic native or proficient speakers. And then get as much speaking practice as you can. In the word often, do you pronounce the T? You can. You don't have to. Often, often. You know, it's probably more common not to pronounce the T, often, from my experience. What series do you recommend to intermediate learners? I'm going to make a video on this soon. I'm going to make a video on what series to watch, what TV shows to watch to improve your English. It's going to be a lot of fun. Guys, by the way, if you have enjoyed this lesson, please just take that time to give it the thumbs up. And then also share it. Share it with your friends. I'd be really happy if you did that. Is there some framework for learning English? Yeah. My book, The 5-Step Plan for English Fluency. Like I said, I get so many emails from people telling me that this book has just changed the way they learn English. I got an email recently saying it changed the way that they approach life. I use this 5-step plan in my life. It's so important. I think it's an incredible book. So download it. Nat Karena, how can I learn English faster? Read this book. Your voice has a therapeutic value. It helps me relax and calm down. Maybe I should make some of those meditation videos. Okay, maybe I should start making them where I can say, you know, sit down somewhere where you're comfortable. Take 5 seconds to focus on your breath. It's really nice. Maybe I should do that. Tell me your main recommendation to keep motivated and learning English. To understand why it's important to really want to do it. In order to achieve a long-term goal with many obstacles, you have to want to do it. You have to really want to do it. And it's important that you do that. So think about ways that English is going to change your life. And I said in a live Facebook lesson yesterday that every day I make notes either on my phone or on my computer, and I just write down things that are important to me. Think reasons why I make a video on YouTube, reasons why I want to get 200,000 subscribers on YouTube, the reason why I spend all this time. And I write things down about my family, about myself, about helping as many people as possible. And it just keeps me motivated. It really stokes the fire. A great idiom. It stokes the fire, which means it gives me that boost to keep going. Okay? So hopefully that helps. How is it possible to practice speaking in non-English speaking country? To do it online, to go to a language exchange, to mimic native speakers, to shadow. So many ways you can do it. So many ways you can do it. Do you practice meditation? If yes, what type of meditation do you practice? I do about 2 minutes a day meditation. Usually, I do it when I'm just feeling overwhelmed, going back to that word we used before. So, yeah, when I feel overwhelmed, I just take 2 minutes and just focus on breathing and clearing my mind. It's very simple, but it makes a big difference. I really enjoy it too. Fanny says, I can sleep with this voice. So do not listen to this video while driving a car or operating heavy machinery. Your eyes are starting to get tired. I actually listened to those videos when I had problems sleeping, and it made a big difference. It really did. Do you have a Twitter account? I do, @TOFLUENCY. I don't use it, to be honest. But when I post a new video, it automatically shares a tweet. But I don't really use Twitter. I don't have the energy. Like, I use Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. They're the three main things I use. I used to go on Snapchat all the time. I might just do a snap right now. Follow me on Snapchat, TOFLUENCY, okay? And I'll do a snap live on air. Okay. This is kind of strange. But anyway, this is Snapchat. They've updated their terms of service. I'm just going to say, like, hey, Snapchat, it's been a while. I'm just doing a live lesson on YouTube. Make sure you watch it. YouTube.com/tofluency. Are you on Snapchat? Let me know and follow me to Fluency. You can find me on there. And then you can put text on here to say, like, I'm back. I love Snapchat. Why haven't I used it? And I'm going to send it to my story. And then you'll be able to watch that. So add me on Snapchat. Add me on Instagram. Thank you, Gemma, for doing that. Mara says, I miss your snaps. I miss doing them as well. I just sometimes with Snapchat, well, because I want to focus so much on YouTube, on Facebook, and on Instagram, it can be kind of difficult to do other things as well. But I'll do more snaps. Now you're becoming a therapist. I am. Yeah. I'm stuck at intermediate. What to do? Okay. This is a problem. If you're at an intermediate level and you feel stuck, feel like you can't keep going, then there are many things you can do. Firstly, read that book. Read that book to fluency.com/book. And then think about why you want to learn English. And then know that you're going to have to make changes. If you are stuck, you're going to have to change what you're doing. You're going to have to do different things or make it more fun. Or maybe spend more time doing it. But I think it all starts with knowing why you want to do this. Understanding the reasons why you want to get to that advanced level so that you can feel energized and motivated and happy about improving. Mara says, yeah, using too many apps is overwhelming. It can be. What is your Facebook page name? I'll put it in the chat. I'll put it here and everyone can see it. FBTF. There it is. Facebook.com/tofluency. Okay, everybody, I'm going to leave it there. This has been a long lesson. Again, if you have enjoyed it, please give it the thumbs up. Please share it with your friends. And if you're watching the replay, leave a comment. So, what a morning. I'm just going to roll with the punches. And I'm going to have a fantastic rest of the day. I hope you have a fantastic day too. And I hope to see you in the next lesson. So, thank you for being here. Speak to you soon.